I make weed infused edibles. I know it's illegal, but I don't feel like I'm doing anything wrong. I don't think I could get caught and be able to maybe talk my way out of it a bit. I would love if it was available in the NHS. We have got a family approaching from behind you. So this is the kitchen we're in this week. I need to get my apron on actually. Yeah. How does that look? I run one of the many infused baked goods companies that exist online. Basically weed infused edibles for people who want to have a good time, or for people who are seeking a medicinal benefit that they can't get over the counter with legal drugs. So we've just got some samples here from this week. Oh, let me see which is which. We've got some Afghani haze here, and then we've got some Gorilla Glue. I'm not gonna claim that I'm doing this for charity or Robin Hood. It does make me money. It makes the people who I work with money. Here's my Blue Peter moment. Here's something I made earlier. Fruity Pebble bars, if you will. I decorate these, don't I? Presentation. You know, I like a lot of cooking shows, and you never get through to the final rounds if it looks like dog shit. I'd be disingenuous if I didn't tell you that 80-85% of the people are looking to just have it recreationally. But there's a variety of things that people do want alternative medicine for. Pain and sickness, sleep. It all began with a lady who was disabled, very sick. She asked if I knew anyone who could get her something to help with her pain relief. I basically said, well, I'm a good baker and I think I could maybe make you some edibles. Long story short, that was the first batch I ever made, and that was a few years ago. Brownies is our number one. Lollipops, birthday cakes. We even just sell the butter that we produce that's infused. People normally get in contact through social media. We use discreet messaging apps where they protect the people both ordering and ourselves. Nobody ever meets. Let's do it. There is no average dose. People could take too much. It's a tool at the end of the day. And if I give you a hammer and you smash yourself in the groin with it, I mean, so yeah, I'm happy with those brownies. Got to cut them up now. That's good. We've got four lollies, two extra strength brownies, two lemon drizzle slices, 16 little crispy bites, and five cookies. Might be £120 worth. I'd love to do this legitimately. Pay taxes on it, all of that, but I can't. Every single box gets the seal of approval. Actually, no, it's the real good stuff. And now I need to pack it and get it ready for postal. Right, should I take this off? Ugh. So now I need to enlist Her Majesty's Postal Service and getting it where it needs to go. By keeping it purely just postal, it keeps me and the others safe and keeps the person receiving it safe as well. I wish I could just show my face. I'm not ashamed about what I do or the things I enjoy. Hopefully, if legalization ever happens in my lifetime, we've already got a brand that's known. If they said I wasn't encouraging the normalization of cannabis use, I'd be upset, because that's exactly what I am doing. I want people to see that it should be normalized. It feels good. It feels good when I get the text back saying that, oh, that was amazing. I'm not a criminal. I don't think I would go to prison for a long time. And if I did, I mean, that might be a consequence, but it's a bullshit one, so I'm not gonna worry about it.